If you've been wondering about a 203k loan and how it works, then you're in the right place. Hi, this is Scott Hastings with Mortgages by Scott. And I've been getting a lot of calls and emails lately about FHA 203k renovation loans and also the conventional loan as well. If you're wondering about a conventional version, which is called a homestyle loan, I have another video on that. And I'll put it in the comments section below, a link to it. By the way, if you find this video helpful at any point along the way, please hit the like and subscribe button. That really helps me out a lot. But anyway, back to the FHA 203k loan. So just a very simple description of what the loan is. It's just a normal FHA loan, but what it does is it allows you to borrow the money for any repairs you want to do to the home at the same time as you buy the house and just get one 30-year fixed loan. The money goes into an escrow account, the money for repairs after you close, and then the contractor, the licensed contractor that's going to do the work, takes draws from that escrow account as the work is done after closing. That's the basics of it. Of course, there's more to it. If I was going to go through this and say, what are the steps to getting qualified for an FHA loan? More than any other loan there is, I would say definitely you have to get qualified first. Obviously, I am a loan officer licensed in multiple states, and I've done a lot of mortgages over the last 20 years. And if there's any advice I can give you, is you must get qualified first. And the reason why is, of course, you have to find out what is your credit score. You know, how do you just in general qualify for a mortgage? But before you go look at houses, you have to know how much loan you can qualify for. You might see a house that is in your price range. You just want to do some repairs. But you need to sort of know, you know, how much repairs can I do? That's going to dictate whether you can buy the house and do what you want. I mean, the house might even be in such disrepair that you can't even live in it yet. So it could be a lot. To restate that, definitely get pre-approved, not just pre-qualified, for an FHA loan before you even go look at houses and even think about doing this. The second advice I would say is when you're talking to your realtor about this, you know, hopefully they have some experience doing renovation loans. a lot of times they don't. And the reason you need someone hopefully that has some experience with it, at least with buying houses that need repairs, are there's a lot of due diligence that needs to be done. and I've often seen realtors or real estate agents write contracts that have the same time frame for closing as a normal loan, and it's just not the case. A renovation loan, an FHA 203K, or home style loan is going to take much longer. The reason is there's a lot more moving parts and more people involved in the mortgage. probably the longest portion is the homeowner agreeing with the contractor on everything that needs to be done. So step two, make sure that you hopefully find a real estate agent that's got some experience with FHA loans or 203K loans. Also, another step is you don't want to be bound by a sales contract on a house. You don't want to have too much money that you can't get back into the deal as far as, well, in North Carolina, it's due diligence and earnest money, two different checks. The reason is you may go into the house and find out that the repairs you wanted to do just aren't going to work for this loan. You definitely have to have a licensed general contractor that's going to do all the work. This is a big point. A lot of times I have homeowners that are interested in this loan because they're do-it-yourselfers. Unfortunately, there's very little work you can do as the homeowner. All of the work has to be done by a general contractor. And I've also had the question, well, what if I am a general contractor? It doesn't matter. You can't do work on your own house, even if you are a licensed general contractor yourself. You'll have to hire someone else. you know, when you are looking at the repairs, what can be done? Well, really, almost anything. Just to name off sort of a bullet list, you know, you can repair roofs and gutters, heating and cooling systems, you know, carpet, flooring, kitchens, bathrooms, replace the windows and doors, do painting and siding, you know, replace plumbing, electrical, you know, do mold remediation, lead remediation, repair water damage. You know, you can add rooms. You can split up rooms. You can, you know, cut two rooms down to one room. You can repair well and septic, et cetera, et cetera. So really, as long as the work you are doing on the house will result in an appraised value that will cover the cost, then you're really okay. That's the main thing. And that is a big part. Sometimes I've seen people go in and they're interested in this loan, but really the things they're wanting to do to the house, they're not going to increase the value of the house enough to make it work. So you have to cover the cost of acquisition plus repairs, which is basically taking the price of the house plus the contractor's bid. The actual math is times 113%, and it has to appraise for at least that. So just to make it easy, it just needs to be worth the purchase price plus the repairs, you know, to make this loan work. I might have mentioned this before, but the longest part of this process is getting to a final contractor's bid that works. The reason is you can't just add stuff at the end. You have to get a contractor, and for example, it has to be a very detailed bid. If you want an example of a bid, you can reach out to me. My website's mortgagesbyscott.com, and I'm happy to send you an example of a sample contractor's bid. But for example, let's say you want to redo the kitchen. You want to take out all the cabinets and you want to put in a new dishwasher and a new stove and a new refrigerator. Well, the contractor's bid is going to have to say removal of cabinets, whatever, $1,000. Disposal waste fee, you know, $300. New cabinets from Lowe's with SKU number XYZ41327, you know, et cetera, et cetera. So very detailed. And also what they're going to do, what you have to do, is they're going to put in about, it's a 15% cost overrun feature. So for easy math, if you're going to do $10,000 worth of repairs, you're going to have to put $11,500 into the escrow account after closing. That's in case the you know, the job goes over. There'll be enough money to complete it. So if it doesn't go over and there's money left in the escrow account after all the work's done, that extra money just goes to pay down the balance on the loan. So it's not lost money. another thing that you will have to do and is very smart to do, I've had to save really homeowners a lot of headaches. You have to have a 203K loan consultant and a 203K home inspector. So a 203K home inspector is, you know, they're a home inspector, but they are qualified to do 203K home inspections. The reason is they can go into the house, they know what has to be repaired for a home to meet minimum requirements. And for instance, I had a client one time, they were going to buy a house. They were all set to well, actually they were under contract. But the 203K home inspector went, got under the house. He found out that there were major structural issues and there was just no way that the cost of those repairs with the purchase price of the house were going to work out. And so they backed out of the contract. So that's another thing. You will have to get a 203K home inspector, and that is money well spent. So those are the major points of a 203K home loan. A lot of times I have people come to me, they want to do this. We get them pre-approved. They go look for houses. And really they just end up at the end of the day realizing it's just too much of a headache. And they end up just buying a regular house. But I also have clients who realize that, you know, there's a lot of moving parts. It is a big undertaking. And if you're willing to take that project on, you can really get a lot of equity. Just to be blunt, make a lot of money. One other thing I want to mention. It has, for FHA loan, FHA 203K loan, it has to be a primary residence. The minimum down payment is 3.5%. What is really cool about it is you can buy a duplex, triplex, or quadruplex, and as long as you live in one of the units, you can still put 3.5% down. And then we get into some other FHA underwriting guidelines about how you can qualify, basically like house hacking, for lack of a better word. But if you have questions about that, just put them in the comments section or reach out to me. Again, this is Scott Hastings with Mortgages by Scott. If you found this video helpful, it would be awesome if you could click like and subscribe, and feel free to reach out to me directly through my website, mortgagesbyscott.com. All right. Thanks a lot.